dog, she went and when she ate some alphabet soup, then what happened was bizarre.
On the way to Martha's stomach, the letters lost their way. They traveled to her brain, and now
she's got a lot to say. Now she speaks.
How now, brown cow?
Martha speaks. Yeah, she speaks and speaks and speaks and speaks and speaks.
What's a caboose? What are we eating again?
Martha speaks.
Hey, Joe, what do you know? My name's not Joe.
She's not always right, but still that Martha speaks.
Hi there.
She's got a voice, she's ready to shout. Martha will tell you what it's all about. Sometimes wrong, but seldom in doubt. Martha will tell you what it's all about. That dog's unique.
Testing, 1, 2.
Hear her speak. Martha speaks and speaks and speaks and speaks and
communicates, enumerates, elucidates, exaggerates, indicates, and explicates, bloviates, and overstates, and hyperventilates.
Martha, to reiterate, Martha speaks.
Today's show is all about entertainment. You'll hear words like pantomime, rehearsing, routines, and star.
Nice try.
You've got the wrong show. Today's show is about painting. Listen for words like painting, artwork, and sculpture.
You mean I bought these tap shoes for nothing?
Relax, you're both right. Today's show is about all kinds of arts, painting and performing. So enjoy!
Ha-cha-cha-cha-cha!
Very realistic artwork, Alice.
That means it's very good.
Actually, realistic means it looks like things in real life. It looks like something you could see. Now, Helen's portrait of a dog on the phone is not realistic.
That's realistic, Mr. Vidinci. It's Martha talking to Grandma.
But it's not realistic because dogs don't talk on the phone.
Mine does. I'll have her call you later.
Huh? Oh, look at that! A zebra flying a plane is not realistic. TD, what is your artwork trying to tell us?
Well, my artwork is trying to tell us that I like zebras, but the legs and feet are too hard to paint.
Oh, well, you and Helen are obviously interested in animals. Would you two like to be a part of my animal painting course at the zoo?
Yes!
Yeah!
Will there be zebras?
Yes, there will. Be at the zoo Saturday morning, 8 a.m.
I'm gonna learn to draw zebra feet.
Have you seen my beret?
Your beret?
Yeah.
I think it's behind that thing that holds your paper up while you paint.
You mean the easel?
Right, behind the easel.
You're right.
Why are you up so early? It's Saturday morning.
I'm participating in the animal painting course at the zoo.
Participating?
Yeah, you know. Participate means you do something with other people, or in this case, animals. Like the way you participated in the school play, and the dog show, and...
Helen, hurry up! The zebras won't wait all day.
Or maybe they would.
Coming! Now I feel like a painter.
Why take a course at the zoo when you have a perfect animal model right here?
I know, but I don't want to bother Skits.
Now I understand why other animals don't talk to people.
Martha, I was joking.
Whoa, who can paint on an easel that tall?
Maybe we're learning stilt painting.
Mr. Vidinci, which easels and brushes are for us?
Oh, hi. Don't move. You're just in time. The animals are about to arrive.
Wow, these must be the animals that are gonna pose so we can paint their portraits.
You think any of these animals could pose better than, say, oh, I don't know, a dog?
Shh! Here they come!
Wow! There's my zebra!
Here come our artists now!
Wait, they're the artists?
Well, this is the animal painting course. The animals do the painting. Did I forget to say that?
Uh-huh.
Make room for Jeffy, please!
Whoa! Ah!
If they're the artists, what are we?
You help me replace the paint jars, brushes, and paper on the easels.
I never knew animals could paint.
Yes, they... Your dog talks.
I told you.
Does this mean I don't have to call him on the phone?
Anyway, elephants are known to be great painters.
Wow,
that's amazing.
Really? I did not know that.
I'll show you. This is Bert Hillsrum, the famous Indian elephant artist.
Wow, look at that.
Amazing.
Those are realistic paintings. They look just like real life.
Elephant artwork sells for a lot of money. That's why we're having this painting course. The zoo needs money. The more animals we can find who will paint, the better the chances the zoo won't have to close.
Close? What would happen to the animals?
We'd have to find them other homes.
A zebra could live in my yard! And I could fit a hippo under my couch!
I think he means in zoos or animal refuges, not in your house.
Aww.
You can't close the zoo! I have the best conversations here! Nothing personal.
Well, we have one elephant participating, so we have hope.
Paint, you animals! Put those brushes on the paper! Let's see. Artwork! If you need a model, just whistle.
Hey, don't eat the art supplies! Ah, you don't know where that brush has been!
Jeffy!
Whoa, zebra! Whoa!
See? Nice brush!
This isn't going well. Oh, hi. No. No one's using those. You may as well play with them. Because I don't think they're gonna be used to make any artwork.
Not a great group. No paintings and the 8-7 brushes. I'm not even sure anyone would buy these as abstract art.
Should I throw away these scraps of paper?
He says not to throw it away. He's not done. I think he's building a nest.
Okay. How'd Jeffy do?
Jeffy's the real disappointment. I expected him to be the best because he's an elephant.
And we saw a video of an elephant who painted flowers as realistic as yours.
So then the zoo animals all painted pictures and you saved the zoo?
Well, not exactly.
But we're trying again this Saturday with different animals.
I can't wait to see what animals we'll be painting today.
I'll bet it's a lion.
Or maybe a bear.
It's art time!
That's it? Just Jeffy? Where are all the different animals?
Well, there were supposed to be others, but when we gave them the art supplies yesterday, we found out they really weren't artistic. Alligator, tiger, snake. Altogether, the animals ate 49 brushes and the gator ate his easel.
Oh, at that rate, we're losing money, not making it.
It's all up to Jeffy. It's all up to Jeffy. Up to Jeffy. Jeffy, wait! Come back!
Uh-oh. What do you think they'll put here? A mall?
Oh, hi again. We saved that stuff for you. I knew he was building a nest. At least he'll have a home when the zoo's gone.
Why won't Jeffy paint?
Martha could ask him.
She can do that?
Sure. Never hurts to ask. Jeffy, could I ask you a question? He said yes.
I'd hate to see what he does for a no.
Jeffy, are you not painting because you don't have the right model?
Martha.
I could be heroic, afraid. Or perhaps you'd like to paint an abstract.
Just talk to him, Martha.
Okay. Jeffy, do you have a problem with painting? Why won't you participate? He says he wants to participate. He wants to save the zoo, but he's too shy and he doesn't know how to express his true talent.
That's it? He's shy? We can fix that.
been in there a long time.
He's done.
Incredible.
That's beautiful.
It's perfect. I'll go get Mr. Vidinci.
Jeffy, you saved the zoo single-handedly.
I mean single-trunkedly.
Jeffy, your paint jars are still full, and your brush is dry.
They are. How did you paint without paint?
How did these peanuts get in the printer?
Jeffy, you didn't paint that.
Oh, he says he's sorry. He didn't want to let everyone down, and he knew we all wanted a nice picture to sell.
So Jeffy saved the zoo?
Not exactly.
Oh, we're doomed!
He says, would it be okay if he used his true talent to try to save the zoo?
What does he want to do?
Really? He wants to dance!
Dance?
People might pay extra to see a dancing elephant.
Jeffy's dancing is gonna really help the zoo!
Hey, you guys! Is that sculpture for sale?
What sculpture?
You wanna buy that bird nest?
That's not a nest! It's a sculpture of Martha made out of paper!
Oh.
Whoa, that's so cool!
Finally, someone recognized a good model when they saw one.
Could you do a sculpture of a zebra for me?
He says the legs are too hard.
Tell me about it.
Hey, would he make more for the zoo to sell?
He'd be happy to.
This may become the most popular zoo in the state.
Or at least the weirdest.
There are lots of different kinds of paintings you can paint. For instance, portraits. Portraits are paintings of people. Or dogs. Landscapes are pictures of the countryside. But my favorite style of painting is abstract painting. Abstract paintings aren't a picture of anything. Abstract paintings are just shapes and colors. Abstract paintings can be all squiggles and lines. Or my favorite, drips and splatters. You really have to go crazy! Fling that paint! And there's one other kind of painting I like. House painting.
So, are you guys excited about Granny Flo's talent show?
Talent show?
Don't any of you read my newspaper? No wonder circulation's lousy. Granny Flo is hosting an old-fashioned programa de variedades, variety show.
Wait, is it a real talent show, or is it just those two guys who are always trying to steal Martha?
Oh, it's real, all right.
What's the prize?
Whoever has the best act wins a year's supply of alphabet soup.
Who wants a year's supply of soup?
For Martha.
Forget the prize. I just want to meet Brian Oceanzest!
Brian Oceanzest!
The host of International Icon?
Uh-huh. He's judging Granny's competition, and the winner gets to be on International Icon!
Whoa!
I've got the perfect old-fashioned act. The old! Da-da-da-da-da!
Trust me, Brian Oceanzest is not going to be impressed by some goofy armpit serenade.
He's una estrella.
A star.
He's used to high-class entertainment.
Oh, high-class entertainment.
It's high class, it's old-fashioned, and boy, am I entertained! You win!
Wow. I've gotta ask Helen.
I can't. I'm already doing a routine with Carolina.
Carolina is entering the vaudeville show?
After what happened in the school play?
Oh, rat!
I know. I couldn't believe it either. But when I asked if she was sure, she said...
Are you joking?
But why?
Dos razones. Two reasons. Brian, Ocean says...
Carolina? Performing? What if she gets stage fright again and can't say her lines?
I already thought of that. We're doing a pantomime.
What's a pantomime?
Missed again!
Pantomime is when you act without saying any words. Like this.
Get it.
Neither do I.
What?
Hey!
I'm not taking my eyes off this floor.
I wonder if Alice needs a partner.
I wish I could, but I've got an act.
What is it?
I was going to do a plate spinning act, you know, with a lot of dinner plates all spinning at once on sticks, but it's weird. It's like no one has any spare plates in this town.
Yeah, weird.
My mom says I should stick to something safer. So, I'm doing a tap dance routine. Watch!
sorry. Now that was entertaining.
Hey, TD, what's up?
I wish I had an entertaining act.
I wish I had a year's supply of soup.
Hey, Martha, I've got a great idea. Let's be partners. We'll go halfsies on the soup.
Oh, you're on! So what kind of old-fashioned act should we do?
Beats me. I don't know any, but I know someone who will. Someone really, really old.
Oh, Santa Claus?
No, my dad. Careful! Don't goop up the page.
Sorry, what is this?
It's a book I got from my dad on old-fashioned stage acts. Maybe we can find an act we can both do. Hey, juggling! Neat! Ready? Here goes!
This is gonna be hard without hands.
What can you do without hands? Acrobatics? Nope. Trapeze act?
No.
Hey, musical glasses! And you can sing along! I played Mary Had a Little Lamb on the water glasses once.
Oh, there's still time. We'll think of something. I hope.
Whoa! Hey, you walked through our rope.
We're rehearsing here. I mean, you do know what that means, right? Rehearsing?
Does it mean looking silly?
No. Rehearsing means you do something again and again until you get good at it. It's like practicar, practicing.
You'd get good faster if you had a real rope, you know.
We can't. It's pantomime. There are no ropes in pantomime. There's no real anything. What are you doing?
Pantomime.
Back to rehearsal. We got a show to practice for.
Whoa! I've got to get this calendar fixed. Yikes! The variety show is tonight!
I know. And we still don't have an entertaining routine.
I give up. We're never going to think of anything. What can I get for a nickel?
Bye-bye, soup.
So long, stardom. Hey, this might cheer you up. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Sherwood.
Sherwood who?
Sherwood would like you to open the door.